are live here at the Oscar viewing party. Go ahead and introduce yourself to Duke and Duchess TV.
I am here by Cesar from Pasadena. I'm sponsoring the hairdressing.
Nice, nice. So, is there anything you're looking forward to this evening?
A lot of good spirit and positive thinking in what's coming this way.
Is there an Oscar your way?
Yes, I'm looking to see a nice Oscar winning.
Yes.
Yes, definitely.
Is there anyone you're really excited to see, like, win an Oscar or anything like that?
I mean, all actors are good. I'd like to see a peaceful Oscar this year.
There was some drama last year. Do you think we'll have a peaceful one?
I think so. Will Smith is a hell of an actor. You know, I mean, I watched the Chris Rock comedy, and he still cares a lot about Will Smith.
Yes.
They're hard to come by. What happened? It was a mistake.
Yes, in front of everybody.
Yes.
Come on over. How are you?
I'm good. What energy today? Oh, my God.
I'm good. I can't get enough of this outfit. Okay. Where can I get this from?
Oh, my face from India. I have my design in India, in Bombay. I have another design in Pradesh. Home design is very exclusive for my brand, the Samira Networks.
Oh, wonderful. And just go ahead and introduce yourselves to those who don't know you at Duke and Duchess TV.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Say hi. Hi, my name is Saul Maxwell. Saul Maxwell, the best healer, the Beverly Hills International. I'm here for everybody. Go energy all the time, positive energy. That is my plan.
I love that. I love that. Is there anything you're most excited for today?
Oh, I'm so excited because too many winners today in Oakland, American Oakland. The best actor party top in Beverly Hills, Hollywood, Samira Network. Remember, the best top party. Samira Network.
Okay.
I think everybody, people happy for Samira Network today.
Yes, thank you so much and enjoy yourself today.
Thank you so much, sweetie. Thank you, my super fan international. I love you, everyone.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Nori Rosen.
Nice to meet you, Nori. Your dress is so beautiful. Can you tell us a little bit about it? Who are you wearing, baby?
Well, not anything in particular, but I found something that fits.
Nothing wrong with that, and it's working. It's working wonderful for you. So tell me a little bit more about you. Like, what brings you to the gala?
Okay, we are in the movie Love and Karma, and also I'm in another movie that we're filming right now.
Uh-huh. How can we see Love and Karma?
Well, she's the executive producer.
The executive producer of Love and Karma.
I'm Celeste Friedman, and we're under development and soon to be in production, so just watch out for the announcements. It will be sometime this year.
Okay, well, I will definitely be looking out. Is there anything we're most excited about today?
Oh, the sushi.
The sushi. Where is the sushi? I've been looking for the sushi. What time does the sushi come out?
It's just exciting to be here.
This is my good friend Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Hi. Robert came all the way from Bali.
Bali?
Yes.
So family
I'm
Bali.
Supporting his charity, and it's a wonderful charity. It brings medical support to the very underprivileged.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
More than 3,000 people in Bali.
Wow.
Physically and mentally impaired. Yeah. And this lady is supporting us, and we're deeply
wonderful.
Grateful.
Yes, yes.
Deeply grateful.
We're having
really.
Fun. They're afraid that he fits in with the Hollywood crowd. He's never going to go back.
And I have none other than Miss Thai USA, Franny. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm really great. So I don't know too much about Miss Thai USA and how that works. So can you walk me through a little bit of how do you get to become, or anybody, not just you specifically, but anybody get to become Miss Thai USA?
Well, in my community in the Los Angeles area, I've helped out multiple Thai events in that community. And the event organizer that hosts the North Hollywood Thai Town Songkran Festival recognized me as, a queen for the Miss Thai USA charity title holder. So I think it comes with a lot of work and lots of community service to get this title.
Okay, that's really amazing. And so once you become Miss Thai USA, are you forever Miss Thai USA, or how does that work?
For this title, I believe it's for a year.
Okay. Can you do it over again?
Yeah, we usually have a Songkran beauty pageant, and it's once a year. It's in English, Songkran translates into Thai New Year, mm-hmm. so we have that festival once a year.
How old are you, if you don't mind me asking?
I'm 24.
Okay, so you're still young, so you could probably be Miss Thai USA like for many, many more years. So are you based in LA?
I'm actually in the OC area.
Oh, okay, close enough. Okay, so one more question. If you go to Thailand, or is that something that is recognized in Thailand?
Yeah, actually this organization is a big one in the Thai community, and they recognize us from the LA area, so...
So you're kind of a big deal.
I don't know!
Yes, you're a big deal. Your body's your big deal. Well, is there anything you're super excited for today?
I'm really excited to see all the wonderful fashion designs today. I just really love the artistic and creativity that everyone has to offer here, and I just love seeing everybody express themselves. So, yeah.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much, Franny, aka Miss Thai USA.
My name is Reva Serrano, and I'm an associate producer for the movie Hashtag Blessed by the director, Delia Faulkner, Darmar Productions, and this is my very first time doing that.
Wonderful. Congratulations on that. That's a huge accomplishment.
Thank you very much.
So, is there anything you're excited for today?
Oh, of course, watching the Oscars. I mean, you know, but also just meeting new people and just kind of getting a feel for how this all works.
Right, right. Do you think we'll have a little drama at the Oscars today?
Little drama?
Yeah.
I hope not.
I hope not.
Just want to have fun.
I think it's going to be a peaceful one. Nothing too crazy going on.
Yeah, I agree.
So, do you have any upcoming projects that we should look out for?
Well, I know the director that I've been supporting, she does have another movie in the works, The Christmas Witch, Delia Faulkner. The Christmas Witch.
Okay.
So, we'll be looking forward to that project.
Okay. Oh my God, this dress. This dress is everything.
Everything. So am I.
You are. Especially someone who admits it.
Thank you.
So.
Living our best life.
We are. Your suit is awesome also. Love the yellow tie. It was a fashion risk, but I love it. I really love it.
Risk and reward.
Yes, exactly. Reward.
Why not take a risk on a night like this?
So tell us more about you all. Duke and Duchess TV has never interviewed either of you.
Yeah.
So I'm really excited for all these new wonderful faces.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for being here. So go ahead and to our watchers at home, tell us about yourself.
Yes, so my name is Crystal Lynn Prevett. I own a company called Mindset Service that's here on the red carpet. I help people remove triggers, trauma, and stress from their subconscious mind. So I upgrade you into something more beneficial instead of the programs that were running us from childhood.
Wow, and how long have you been doing that?
About 3 years now.
That's amazing.
Yeah, mom's one of my clients.
Wow, how do you get involved in something like that?
So I had a childhood that was full of a lot of trauma, mm-hmm. like many people here, and I didn't know that I was attracting more of it in my adult life. Mm-hmm. I had no idea that like we were attracting more of the negativity, and so when I found out we could feel differently, I was like, oh my gosh, this is like revolutionary, like how innovative that we can feel more positively and react differently to the things happening to us in life.
That's amazing, and you're a real life client.
I am, so yes. I can absolutely speak to it.
Can you tell us anything about it?
Yeah, well, I mean, as it's funny, we were talking earlier, as a male, you know, sometimes it's hard to be vulnerable and open up a little bit, and we all can admit that we need help sometimes, and so once I met Crystal and started working with her, the changes are immediate and amazing, so just much more positivity and everything, so she's awesome at what she does, that's for sure.
Thank you for that. I really appreciate you telling us that. Is there anything you're excited for this evening?
Well, this is my first time being to anything like this at all, so I just told her I'm trying to soak it all in. The whole red carpet experience is amazing, and so far I've met a lot of really great people, so looking forward to spending time with my friend and enjoying tonight, so
wonderful.
Kind of definitely an experience.
Wonderful, and where can we find out more about what you do?
MindsetService.com, I help you build new neurological pathways for supreme success.
Hi, we got Lil Saint here at the Luxury Gala, how are you?
I am doing awesome, how are you?
I'm doing awesome, I love the red and black, such a good coordination. So, what What brings you here?
Just seeing friends and enjoying the networking. I have a podcast, and so I'm here to make new networking connections and bring other people onto my show.
Wonderful. I got a little podcast myself. Yes, I was on a little hiatus, but now I just finished my master's degree, so now we're coming back soon. So okay. I love podcasts. I'm a radio girl. So what's
I can see.
So tell me more about your podcast.
So it's called The Little Saint Show Power Hour. Basically what we do is we bring all sorts of types of entrepreneurs, business owners, actors, actresses, comedians, and basically yours truly, Little Saint.
Bringing
motivation, everything to the world.
Okay, and is it on Spotify, Apple, all that?
Yes, we are on YouTube, Spotify, Facebook, everything that you just mentioned. You can catch us every Thursday, 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Wonderful.
So just go to youtube.com/@TheLittleSaintShow, L-I-L Saint Show.
All right, make sure y'all go check that out, all right?
Cindy Ashton.
Okay, I didn't get that last one.
What's your name?
Nicole, a.k.a. Nikki of Duke and Duchess TV. I love this outfit.
Garo Sparrow.
Say it again for the people.
Garo Sparrow. He is designed for Madonna, Lizzo, and
Now you.
And now me.
Okay, you are up there.
Maybe.
I absolutely love it, and it gives us such a warrior vibe. I'm getting a warrior, like, yes. Is that what you're going for?
Yes, it's about feminine power, but not the aggression. People think feminine power is like, and it's not. Feminine power is this rooted, grounded, earthy, I know my power, I be my power, I express my power.
Yes. And it's Women's History Month, so you have to.
It is.
You have to
it
show
is.
Up. So I overheard when I was eavesdropping that you're the opening performer for
I
today.
I am the opening performer for today. It's going to be big. It's going to be Broadway. It's going to be splashy and a homage to a movie musical that actually won an Oscar many years ago.
Ooh, that's all you're going to tell. So you have to watch. You have to watch. I love that. Well, thank you so much
thank
for coming
you.
On down. Pleasure.
Such a joy.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. We have someone who is no stranger to Duke and Duchess TV. We have none other than Raister Michael.
Hello. Good times.
Such a pleasure to see you again. How you been?
I'm great. Just working, doing things, you know.
Getting what are you working on these days? You're always busy.
Well, we got a movie called Night Mistress coming out soon.
Oh, yes.
But we're going to start another one called Death Realm, The Haunting Begins. And he's got big stars like Mark Hamill, Doug Jones, Robert Picardo, Lee Arenberg, and Kevin Bacon.
Ooh.
And I'm trying to get... from Star Wars. Darth Vader. James Earl Jones, because I love James Earl Jones. So I'm trying to get him. I mean, he's in New York and stuff. And he's a little older, so we're just trying to get him here.
Okay.
And yeah, that's going to happen soon. A couple months.
I know you're going to make it happen.
Yes. Fun stuff.
Are you excited for anything today at this event?
Yeah, this is great. I mean, all of it is beautiful. I love all the people. It's so much fun. Everybody's having a good time, right?
Think we're going to have some drama at the Oscars today?
Yeah, of course. There's always drama. That's the fun part.
Yes.
Drama.
I'm hoping for a little drama.
Something fun. Yeah. Absolutely.
All right. So how can people keep an eye out for your next movie, Night Mitch?
Well, right now they can go to Facebook and put Raister Michaels or Dream Cinema Productions, Instagram, all those social medias. The movie is being advertised out there.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much, Raister. It's always a pleasure to interview.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're the best. Thank you so much.
So, tell me who you are.
I am Claudette J. Devereaux. I'm the visual artist. I travel globally. I write for Nature Photography Magazine. I do wildlife, seascape, and landscape photography.
Wow, that's amazing. First of all...
I'm a pioneer.
Okay, that's what I was about to say.
Oh, yeah.
We don't see too many of us doing that. I knew I was going to be shocked today somehow. So, thank you. Are you familiar with, like, outdoor afro and things like that? Yeah. So, my mind immediately thought of that.
I'm on cliffs and in helicopters and things like that.
Yes.
That's what I do.
I'm coming back to you.
My name is Chrissy Linton. I'm Claudette's daughter.
Okay, I heard you like, Mom, I gotta go, or something like that. When I was eavesdropping, I heard y'all over there.
I'm a flight nurse from North Carolina.
Right on. Okay, so have you been working with Raister a long time, I'm assuming?
I've known Ray for about 3 years, and my work is gonna be in his next movie.
What? Okay, Night Mistress?
No, the one after that.
Oh, okay, okay. I will be looking out for that. I will be like, I know that work.
There you go.
Okay, well, let's see who else is here. Who else is here? Down. I love the jacket.
Hi, I'm Michael Quiroga. I'm Ray's brother. So, I help him with the films. I'm also a lawyer, so I help him on the contract side. I'm also a lawyer at Custom Associates. I'm going to be opening up also Genshef and Quiroga PC. We like to help out entertainers, the ones that need help, and in the industry. Lots of times, we hope everything goes well, but if something goes wrong, you never know when you need a good lawyer to help the entertainers to go forward and help for their rights.
Yeah, I need a lawyer. Duke and Duchess TV needs a lawyer, okay?
Even the lawyers need lawyers.
I know. Who does the lawyer call? And last but not least?
Ivo Genchev, I'm a lawyer too. We work together with Mike. That's my sister, Elena.
Okay, hi.
And we also love movies.
Movies, right on. Is there anything we're hoping or expecting for today, like anything we're excited about or anything like that?
We're going to have a good time, and we hope the best to win, right?
My brother's going to show the trailer. There's going to be two trailers that will be shown later today some of his upcoming projects.
I'm excited for that. Anybody have any final thoughts before we sign off?
No?
We are here and we are back to normal.
Yes, back to, we can all gather, right?
Yes.
That's a beautiful thing. Let the audience know who you are.
Hi, I'm Dalia Faulkner and I'm a writer-producer.
Writer-producer. Any projects coming up?
Actually, yes, I have one that's currently out. You can watch it pretty much anywhere, streaming all over the place, called #BlessTheMovie.
Oh, I've been hearing about that.
Yeah, and my book that's here as a gift, an exclusive gift for all the attendees, is called The Christmas Witch. I just turned it into a screenplay, so that's the next project.
That's amazing. Congratulations. That's a huge accomplishment. Where are you based out of?
I'm actually in the mountains in Arizona, so four seasons, perfect writing weather, especially when it snows.
Oh, I bet. We just got snow here in California.
I know. I saw. I was like, oh, that's so cool.
And I've only been in snow like twice in my entire life because I'm born and raised in California. In my whole grown life, you know. So anyway,
I love it.
Are you excited for anything today at this event?
Honestly, I'm just so excited to be here with everybody. I'm excited to watch the Oscars. I'm excited to connect with friends and family that I haven't seen in a while. So it's just going to be a beautiful time.
And where's your book at? Because I want to make sure I get one.
It's actually around the corner.
Okay.
You can't miss it. It's a big step.
Okay, I think I saw a table, but I thought it was like something else maybe. So I'm going to make sure I get my copy.
Yes.
And so please tell our audience about yourself.
My name is Martina Webster. I'm a movie producer with my daughter Dalia, who crossed the red carpet earlier.
Yes.
She's an author, and we both produce Christmas movies and movies with meaning.
I love Christmas movies.
Yeah,
I will watch a Christmas movie in June. I do not care.
I hope you do. It's pretty much on all the channels.
Oh my gosh. Okay. So I saw that she had the book also.
Yes.
You must be so proud.
Extremely proud. And just being able to even work with your daughter is incredible.
That's beautiful. And I love your dress.
Thank you so much.
Can you tell us who you're wearing?
Yes, ma'am.
Which one?
I have no idea.
That's okay.
I'm not ashamed to say so.
Me neither.
I ordered it online and there
it's working.
It is.
Working.
I want to green. That's all I
love
can.
It. I love it. Is there anything you're excited about for today's event?
Yes, Sir Earl Toon is a friend of mine, and he's performing today. So it's amazing to see how someone can continue his career and how much people love him. So I'm really excited for that.
Do you have a message for Samira Network or the community or anything like that?
I love Samira. She is a wonderful, good person, and I'm glad she's putting on this event.
Yeah. All right, so tell me who you are.
My name is Albert Silvero.
Albert Silvero.
I'm an actor, producer, sometimes executive director for small feature films, but
okay,
yeah.
Okay, I love that. Any upcoming projects?
Not immediately. It'll be coming up in maybe a year, but not this year.
That's fine. Good things take time.
Exactly.
You
know. It takes time to film these things and it takes time to edit and then put them together and then...
Are you based in Los Angeles?
I am. I'm both San Diego, Los Angeles. I'm back and forth all the time.
Okay. Is there anything you're super excited for this evening?
Oh, geez. Just the people. people, and I'm hoping that the winner takes the best movie maker, gets the best prize. Yeah.
Yes, yes. Are you hoping for anything interesting at the Oscars to happen?
No, not really. I mean, it's I just hope nobody goes slapping anybody. We don't want no more slap fights. Imagine if everybody started slapping each other on there.
That will go down in history.
It'll be fun to watch.
You know, sometimes people just got to get it out. They just got to get it out.
Exactly.
Well, it's been such a pleasure meeting you. How can we find you online or any of your work?
Well, I'm on Albert Silvero. You can find me. Just look me up, and you can find me on Facebook.
We'll be looking. Yeah. I'll be following
you.
Thank you.
I'm Dr. Cheryl Nichols.
Dr. Cheryl Nichols? Oh, okay.
Nicholas, like Santa Claus.
Yes. I love your dress, first of all.
Thank
I see
you
that,
so
I'm
much.
Like,
thank
yay.
You. Thank you.
So, Dr. Cheryl,
yes.
What brings you out today?
Well, invitation from Miss Moore, and we actually share together some common interests and passion in terms of care for the community. And so in my practice, I do mental health services for people with psychiatric disabilities with focus on personal wellness and suicide prevention.
Wow, that's amazing. I've been hearing that a lot today, just through the red carpet, so that's really beautiful, and I'm glad that we're having this platform to promote that, because it's so important, especially now, well, anytime, really. Now it's so prevalent, so I really appreciate the work that you do, because especially communities of color and things like that is just very important.
Absolutely. You know, it was one of those things that COVID helped illuminate.
Yes.
It's always been there, but COVID helped illuminate it, and now we are more comfortable, I would say, in at least addressing the fact that we all have some mental health issues.
Where are you based out of?
North Carolina.
North Carolina! So you came all the way over here.
All the way. Just like mental health is a national issue, I can get across the nation.
Okay, you international. Well, I love that. Thank you so much for stopping
by. Thank you
by.
So much.
Is
Appreciate
there anything
you.
You're excited for this evening?
Oh, I am happy to be a part of this and just celebrate the opportunity for us to just all pause and shine for a moment.
Yes, thank you so much. It's
thank
a pleasure.
You.
So please introduce yourself.
Hi, good evening. My name is Lacey, and I go by Lacey Groove. That is my soul name, and I am a soul singer.
Oh.
Yes, ma'am. So I'm just singing all over at this point.
Okay.
I have a new project coming out in May, and I'm just looking forward to, you know, everything just, you know, going well with the project. And hopefully everybody will get a chance to hear it soon.
What kind of vibe can we expect from this project?
Well, I mean, it's more of a soul vibe. You know, we got some soulfulness in there, and we a lot of up-tempo, you know, and then we got like some of that, as they can call it, crooning.
Mm-hmm.
I do a little of that too, but
love
a lot of the soul vibes, honey. I love soul. It's all in us, and you know we can't get away from it.
And where are you based out of?
I'm actually in Fayetteville, North Carolina.
North Carolina!
We way away from home, honey.
We came all the way over here, too. She's in North Carolina, too.
Really?
Okay. Nice to meet you.
North Carolina, okay. Yes, ma'am.
I love that. I love
Thank
that.
You.
I'm a strong believer of following your passion and your dream wherever it takes you. Like,
yes,
I used
ma'am.
To live in Northern California, and they'd be like, I used to travel down here, and now I live in Southern California.
Really?
So, yeah, I firmly believe, like, just do
Thank
it.
You.
You know, just, that's all you can do. I mean, just step out on faith.
Yes.
And do what, you know, what you're called to do.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I believe, you know, I'm a firm believer in the higher power, and he's not going to lead you in the wrong direction.
Okay.
Now, where can we find your music at?
Well, you can find it on Spotify, iTunes, we got CD Babies. Oh, my God. It's just, if you just Google Lacey, L-A-C-E-E, Groove, and then you'll see all that
okay,
good stuff.
Well, I'll download it tonight.
Thank you so kindly. You are so sweet.
Thank
oh,
so
thank
much.
You.
Enjoy yourself.
Thank you so kindly.
Please go ahead and introduce yourself to our viewers.
Okay, I'm Bev Moore. I'm the host and executive producer of the Bev Moore radio show, talk show actually,
okay.
With iHeart Network Worldwide.
What?
Okay. Yes.
Okay, so when the signs come down, it takes so long. So it'll be like five people ago when I finally get to someone. So I was waiting because I saw you way over there. So I was like, did I miss Bev Moore? I asked somebody over, this lady over here, I was like, are you?
Right.
So I sincerely apologize. But so iHeart, wonderful. So we can just log on and listen.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I have a podcast myself. I'm a radio girl. So
yes.
I did radio in college and a little bit afterwards. And now I do this and a bunch of other things.
Right.
So I still have my podcast. But,
right.
Wow, that's amazing. So is there anything that you're particularly excited for this event?
Well, I'm very honored to be here. I'm a guest. I was featured in the magazine of Heart of Hollywood.
Oh, wow.
So I'm a special guest here.
Congratulations.
So I'm very excited. This is a very exciting event, and I'm just honored to be here. And my show, my talk show, is I feature celebrities and public figures. So it's every Friday at 12 noon Eastern and 9 a.m. Pacific.
Where are you based out of?
Well, the show is based in Texas.
Wow.
But it has 185 stations in 37 countries.
Wow.
Yeah.
You go, girl. Go, girl. So we are here live at the Luxury Gala, and I got none other than Patrika Darvo. How are you doing?
Look at us. We're like sisters from another mister.
Because we are sisters. Yes, we got the email.
We did. We got the email.
So how are you doing?
I'm doing well. Everything. Last night we were in Palm Springs to see Ruta Lee's show. If you get a chance to see Ruta Lee, she's amazing. I mean, she's been around years. She'd kill me if I said how many. Such an iconic performer, but she's so great. I'm so grateful to be in her company and to be asked to be here tonight.
So you're on Days of Our Lives.
Yes, I am.
Yes. That awesome show has been going on a long
time. Thank you,
Ani. I always want to ask people who are on soap operas, how do you stay into that character? Because it's live.
How do you stay in character as fabulous lady? You know, it's you take that on, and the writer's creator, and you get to bring her alive.
Wow.
And that's what it is. I think the hardest is all the lines we have to remember.
Right, the lines. Oh, I'm like, man. And then if something dramatic happens, you're like, and then. But I've always wanted to be on a soap opera, actually, because I'm like, I feel like I could do it.
You're still here.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time out, and it's been a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you, everyone, and I'm sorry it's sort of clustery here. So my sister and I got to say bye to each other. Bye, baby.
Bye, girl. We are live here at the Luxury Gala. You are new to the Duke and Duchess TV platform, so go ahead and please introduce yourself.
Okay, my name is Quinlan Valley. I am an International Plus model / actress. I also won Miss Curvy League 2016, New York City. I've been in the industry for a while.
Wow.
A while.
So that I imagine that had some challenges, like
of
in
course.
The beginning. So how did you navigate that?
God, Jesus, stay prayed up, and just stay focused. You know, because I mean, the hate is gonna come. You know, the critiquing is gonna come. Just keep your mind positive and trust in whatever spirit you trust in, whether it be Jesus, Buddha, whoever.
Yeah. How did you break into plus modeling?
Well, a cousin of mine was already modeling, and she invited me to a model car. I was like, girl, I was like, ended up being in the top 10 that was chosen.
Go ahead. Where are you based out of?
I live in California now, but I'm from Dallas, Texas. That's where I'm from.
Okay, wonderful. So would you mind introducing yourself to our followers?
Hi, I am Cynthia Traveling Queen. Good friend of Samara.
Okay. Traveling queen. So what does that entail?
Huh?
You say you're the traveling queen?
Yes, I'm a world traveler.
A world traveler. I love that. Yes. How'd you become the world traveler? I'm trying to be like you.
Well, I've been traveling the world since 1993. I own my own company, Cynthia Traveling Queen Agency. And you can reach me at CynthiaTravelingQueen.com.
I was born in 1993. So as long as I've been alive.
Just so you know, we were here in 2020 for the Oscar Gala in 2020.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So I didn't get to make that one. I think I was out of town, but my associate was here. But okay, wonderful. So how does
we're just so happy to be here.
I'm excited for you. I love your dress, by the
way.
Love the shininess. It's beautiful, and the hair is popping.
Thank you.
You're the traveling queen. Is there anywhere you haven't been that you still want to go to?
Yeah, I want to go to Tokyo and Greece.
Okay.
We got Italy coming up in May for my birthday, and June 1st. But yeah, I want to go to Tokyo, Greece. It's, you know, some places I haven't been.
Right.
And a lot of times when you go to these exotic places and wonderful places, you'll know where to put your clients when they call in.
Uh-huh. So would you mind introducing yourself to our audience?
Yeah, sure. My name is Vaishali Kumar, and I'm my brand name is Attires, and I am an official designer for My Dream TV. Yeah, and I designed for Rashmi Bedi, who is the CEO of My Dream TV. And I've come all the way to attend New York Fashion Week, and now I'll be showcasing my outfits here today in Oscar's viewing party.
How can I get an outfit?
Oh, you can always get an outfit. I have an extra outfit for you too.
You have an extra for me? Oh my God! I guess I want an outfit so bad.
That will be nice.
Oh my God, thank you. Is there anything you're excited for this evening at this event?
This is my first time I'm, coming for the Oscar viewing party, and I'm really liking, you know, and I really want that people should see what I've designed for my models.
It's what you're wearing is so beautiful. I absolutely love it. Thank you so much.
My name is Caitlin Carabayo.
Caitlin Carabayo.
And I'm actually here also hosting as well. But I found Samir, and she just has a really great event, so I had to check it by.
How do you become Miss West Coast Regional?
Okay, so Miss West Coast Regional is about a pageant that is about charity and about giving back. I'm a part of the Flying Samaritans. I'm a dentist.
You're a dentist! Girl, go ahead on.
Who works with communities in Mexico that have no other reach except for us, who come down and give free healthcare to them.
That's amazing.
So I support that platform, and I try to give it as much awareness as possible.
That's amazing. How long have you been a dentist for?
4 years.
Wow, congratulations. You're just doing it. You're doing it.
You know, to be an inspiring woman, you have to take charge. And you have to find the things that you're good at, find the things that you're weak at, and then roll them all together.
Yes, yes. So you're Miss West Coast Regional and a dentist. What do you not do?
Well, recently, actually, we're working on a project where we're giving women that cannot enter the pageant industry because there is an entrance fee.
That was bothering me.
No, you're fine. And we're giving them an opportunity to do sponsorship so that they can go and be a part of it as well. So
making it more accessible. Oh, that's amazing. That's beautiful. That's really beautiful. Are you excited about anything this event? I know you're presenting, so.
What I'm most excited about is just the party.
Yes.
It's fun to dress up and be a part of a party.
Yes, everyone
right?
looks so amazing. So.
And you just look at people like, oh, I want that for next time.
Right.
I want this.
I've already got ideas. So yeah. I'm like, oh yeah, next time, it's over.
But if you guys want to get involved, please go to my Instagram. It's CATA_Carabayo, CARABALLO. And we're just working on tons of things for people, and I thank you again for having me.
Okay, would you mind introducing yourself to our followers?
Hi, I'm Anjana Sami, and I am with the My TV Dream USA, and I am an Indian model, and I am a businesswoman, and a mom, and a grandma.
A grandma?
Yes, I'm also a pageant winner. So this is who I am.
Wait, who's grandma? Are you?
My two little kids.
You don't look like you should be anyone's grandma ever, because you look like you're 28. Go ahead on, girl. Go ahead on. Where are you based out of?
I live in Denver, Colorado.
Denver?
But I'm born and raised in Fiji Islands.
Fiji, oh, I hear it's beautiful there. I've got some friends from Fiji, and they're always trying to get me to go, and I need to go. Wow, that's amazing. So, Ahmed, you do all these great things. What brings you to this event?
So, same, just wanted to explore something different, new.
Would you mind? I'm unfamiliar with the question mark. I've never seen
it. So, it's kind of part of my my outfit that I'll be wearing tonight. Yes.
Okay, cool. I'll be on the lookout for you.
Yes. And same time, I'm a woman. I'm a big question mark.
I love that.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Gurpreet, and I'm from Colorado. wherein I was the first runner-up.
Wow, congratulations. You should have won.
Yeah, I should have won.
That's what I always say. You should have won.
Yeah.
They robbed you, but it's okay.
It's okay. See, sometimes you give out this opportunity.
Yes. So you have the crown on. I love it. So that's good. You still get to keep your crown. Yes. So are you in any films coming up or anything interesting?
Many Bollywood producers have approached me, Bollywood directors have approached me, so let's see what comes up in the near future. If I say yes.
We'll be seeing you on TV.
I know her! Yeah. It should happen.
So how can we follow you on social media and learn more about you?
So on my Facebook, I have an account of Good Preet Subrook, and on my Instagram, I have an account of GoodPreet_Opan.
Yeah,
my name is Deshaun Stacy, and I'm a writer out of Inglewood.
Inglewood, up to no good, huh? Inglewood. So, working on any projects upcoming?
Yes, I'm working on a novel. I can't drop the name, but I'm working on a novel right now.
Okay.
Yeah, it's my second book.
Okay, what genre is
it? It's like a lighthearted comedy, but it got some gems in there as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
I love literature, so yeah, I definitely will be on the lookout for it. What's the name of your first book?
My first book is titled Wubbas. It's a tricky name because it doesn't mean anything.
Uh-huh.
It's just a nickname I gave to my daughter.
Okay.
Yeah, it's spelled W-U-B-A-S. Wubbas. Yeah, like you know when you have a little baby and her little chubba Wubbas. Yeah, exactly. So I abbreviated it to Wubbas. Exactly.
Oh my
yeah,
God.
Yeah. So it's dedicated to her. It's a memoir dedicated to her.
Beautiful. That's beautiful. Okay, so you got a book coming up. Okay, and so what brings you out here?
I'm just with the family right now. My sister invited me, and so I said I can't miss an Oscar event. You know, I may be there big time later, so I want to get some experience now.
Yes,
that's honest truth.
I like a lot of modern black literature. Like I don't know if you're familiar with like Kiese Layman or like even Roxane Gay or I can't pronounce his name, Coates.
I'm big on the old school, the OGs.
Oh, yeah,
like
the OGs,
Toni Morrison.
Oh yeah.
Maya Angelou I'm big on. Richard Wright, I like his books. Yeah, I read a lot of the OGs.
Yeah.
Because I want to bring something that's fresh to the new school, something that's authentic, something that's like heartfelt, something that you can really feel, something that you can tell that, or that guy put his time into that. You know, it's blood, sweat, and tears. So that's what I'm about.
Well, you'll have to come on my podcast.
Absolutely.
Soon, especially when that book drops and we can talk about it. I'd love to have you.
I'd love to be there.
All right. Well, thank you so much. It was a pleasure meeting you. Congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thank you. So, would you mind introducing yourselves to Duke and Duchess TV?
I'm Jennifer Dwayne.
Drew Dwayne.
Drew Dwayne. Very nice to meet you. What brings y'all out to this event today?
Well, we're out here just, we have our daughter who comes every year.
Okay.
And so we're out here with her today for this event, along with promoting our company, Daylight Entertainment. We're writers, original content for film and television, streaming apps, you know. We currently have a film in production, Book of Hymns, which is going to be, it's going to touch on a lot of really, really serious social issues.
Okay.
That took place in the black community in a small town like 77 years ago.
Wow.
So it's a powerful film. We're proud of it. So we're looking forward to bringing it to the world. Everyone can see.
Congratulations on that. That's huge. That's huge. I cannot wait to see it. So would you mind introducing yourself to our followers?
Okay, yes. My name is Julian Reeves. I go by Lord Julian. I'm a music producer. I'm also a film music supervisor, also for Daylight Entertainment. My company is the Architect Media Group because I feel everyone is an architect of their own life, so they have to develop that.
Wonderful. I like that.
Yeah. So right now we're in production working on Oblivious and other things I don't supposed to talk about, but it's suspenseful and we're having fun and we're just grateful to be here tonight.
Okay. We are live here with Sasha Ann here at the Luxury Gala. First of all, your dress is beautiful. I absolutely love it. Did you have that custom made or?
I was styled.
You were what?
I was styled.
You were styled. Okay. Everyone has a stylist with me. So,
great.
Thank you. I need a stylist. I need someone's stylist number. So, what brings you to this event today?
This is actually my first time being at Samira's Network, and I'm very excited to meet new people and network.
I love that. I love that. Are you in any sort of movies coming up or anything like that?
So I was in a movie 2 years ago. It's called Reed's Point. It's out on Amazon Prime, YouTube, Vudu, and it's still doing amazing. And I have a new song coming out very soon.
What new song?
April 21st, called Scars.
Scars. Okay, yes. We'll be on Spotify?
Everywhere.
Okay, I will be definitely looking for that and downloading. Okay, so you're pretty busy. You're pretty busy. Where are you based out of?
Here.
Okay.
Yes.
Perfect. Well, that's amazing. Congratulations to you on everything. Do you have music already on Spotify?
I do. I have my first cover song, Catch Me I'm Falling, that's out, and my second cover song, This Is Your Night.
What's the vibe of your music?
Dance pop.
Like, yes. Electronic or?
Well, actually, the first one is an 80s hit. So, by Jane Starling.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. I like that. Okay, we will be downloading later. That's what I'm doing today. I'm downloading music today. Okay. Well, do you have a message for Samira's Network or anything you'd like to sign off with?
Yes. I want to tell everyone, just be themselves. I know that during Oscars week, everyone will compare themselves to others and like, oh my gosh, your dress is gorgeous. No, you're beautiful, and just stay positive.
Thank you for that. That was beautiful. Thank you. And good luck with everything. Congratulations. Hello. I love your outfit.
Thank you so much.
So tell me your name.
Jade Starling.
Jade,
I'm actually the lead singer and songwriter at the group Pretty Poison. You know that song, Catch Me I'm Falling?
Yeah,
Catch Me I'm Falling. Actually is in the Golden Globe winning show Dahmer.
Uh-huh.
It's in episode 4. I just found out the show is nominated for an Emmy as well.
What?
So it kind of reinvented my classic hit.
Yeah, I remember it. I watched the series.
And in the meantime, my new single Crazy, I'm already number 2 on the international chart.
Go ahead on.
And my new video just dropped 5 days ago. I've already got over 100,000 views.
What?
So things are really popping right now. Yeah. For me. It's very exciting.
You're busy.
And the genre is more like house.
Okay.
Dance house. Yes.
Love
same.
Music, yes.
Yes. Yes, girl.
Yes. I love your dress. The whole
thank
look.
Thank you. It's Bagley Mishka.
Ooh. And I love the gloves.
Thank you.
Very lovely.
Thank
touch.
You so much. And my stylist, I have to thank him. His name is Lo. He did a phenomenal job. Just
What is his name?
His name is Lo.
Lo. Call me.
Yes, phenomenal.
Okay, well,
you would love him.
Much. Congratulations on everything. It is
thank
such
you.
Awesome.
So nice to meet you, and
yes.
Thank you. And I do have a message in closing.
Please.
I just want everyone to love and respect one another. There's more than enough room for everyone. We should all honor each other and allow each other to shine and never let anyone dim your light.
Yes, thank you for that. That was beautiful. Thank you. It was nice meeting you.
Yes, I'm a costume designer with Hollywood, and I'm also a fashion designer owning 2 brands, all luxury wear. Yeah.
Wow. That's amazing. So can you, we've never been interviewed by Duke and Duchess TV, so would you mind introducing yourself to the people?
Sure. So my name is Primal Bariani. I am a Hollywood film and television costume designer, been in the industry for over 10 years. I've been a fashion designer for over 15 years, and I own 2 brands, both of them, one of them is a export brand, and the other one is a luxury brand, red carpet, pageants, proms, celebrities, you name it.
Okay, well, I gotta get with you because you have all the beautiful designs.
Thank you so much. It's you've got that, you've got the Elvis, you've got the Mervic. There's some really strong women talking, there's some really strong movies out there. I had the pleasure on, well, working with some of the major casts in all of these movies. So I am really excited to see which one takes the men away.
Yes, yes. I'm with you on that. Well, thank you so much for stopping by. And I'd love to connect with you on some fashion.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And we have Worldwide People Choice Award.
It's quite a mouthful.
It is.
Yeah.
You tell them.
All right, I can. Hey, hi everybody. This is Amita Jadhav. I am the runner-up of Miss Bharat California and runner-up of the Miss Bharat USA pageant. And I'm here to walk the ramp for Beautiful Traditions Otijo, showcasing her wonderful collection, which is going to be Indo fusion kind of a costume. And just loving the vibe and loving what we have here today. So we'll enjoy. Yeah.
Congratulations, you should have won, first of all.
Yeah. Well, runner-up is also
runner-up
like winning,
is
right?
Good. Yeah. Like, that's still, you're up there, right?
Yes,
you're still
yes.
There.
Yeah.
And I love your makeup. Did you do that?
No, I have a makeup artist, gorgeous makeup artist who could do that. Yeah, yeah.
Of course you have a makeup artist.
Yeah.
So where are you based out of?
I'm based out of California, closer to San Francisco. And I have a full-time job. I work in the technology space. And I got associated with My Dream TV USA last year, where I was getting into the pageant. And I think that was something that was mind-blowing experience, because this platform is not only about the pageant, but it's all about how you can give back to the community.
Right.
So through this platform, we support the women, we support the small, medium business entrepreneurs, and whatever funds that we raise go back for, you know, the breast cancer research, or for the foundation gives it back to this all the treatment. So I think that is what is most important for me, like, you know, how I can make some meaningful contribution to the society. What I got, how can I pay it forward?
Yeah. That's amazing. That's really big.
So
I'm actually from Stockton, actually. So when you said San Francisco, I'm like, okay, the Bay, you know. So, wow. So do you have any message for the people or anything you want to sign off with?
Yeah, just one message I have. Personally, I'm going through a difficult time right now, but you know, like they say, things will come and things will go. So this is the moment. Seize your opportunity. Seize the moment. You know, there is always light at the end of the tunnel, which doesn't seem like at the moment that you are in. But, you know, the show must go on. So that's how, you know, just be positive. Do your best. Put your best foot forward, I would say, and things will definitely turn around for you.
Thank you. That was beautiful. You are
Mrs. Bharat USA 2021.
Okay, congratulations. So you won.
I did.
You won. Okay,
yes.
You are the it girl. Okay. Congratulations
Thank
on that.
Thank you so much.
And what is your real name? Not your official name.
My name is Divya Mavar.
Okay, very nice to meet you. Yeah. So when you compete in this, what do you have to do?
So it's pretty simple. You just have to put your authentic self out on the stage, and you portray what you stand for. And that's about it.
Okay.
Yeah, so a lot of confidence, amazing outfits, of course, a lot of preparation that goes behind the scene to talk in front of the audience. But what I stand for is real women empowerment. My platform support all small businesses, especially owned by women. So that's my platform.
Oh, I love that. I absolutely love that. So, is there anything that you're most excited for this event?
Oh, I'm walking in a fashion show and I'm super excited. My outfit is amazing. I'm going to be wearing an Indian sequin sari. And my designer is here. I'm super excited to be walking in the fashion
show.
That
is so exciting. I'm a little jealous.
You should come join us. Definitely.
I would love to join us.
Yes.
I want to be in it. I want to.
Yes.
I want to so bad, actually. Well, I'm really excited for you. And when you go up, I'm going to be probably in the back screaming. So, you are new to the Duke and Duchess TV program. So, would you mind introducing yourself to our followers?
Yes. My name is Gina Santopoli. This is Zach.
Hi, Zach.
Hi. How you doing, sweetie?
So, what brings us out today?
You know, we're just looking for a fun time. It's a Sunday, you know?
Just something to... Just you know, put on your nice outfit.
Day in the life of, yeah.
I love that. Your dress is beautiful. Yeah. Right? I don't know if we got.
My name is Gina Santopoli.
Oh, yes, Gina, that's right. Gina, are you in any movies or anything?
Actually, I am not. I just kind of show up.
You know what? I love that for you.
I love
that for you because you are just living your best life.
I'm always living my best life.
Are you excited for anything in particular today?
I'm excited to be here. I'm excited to, of course, watch the Oscars, see who wins. I'm excited for the great food,
yeah.
Alcohol. In fact, I need to go get a drink now, a
okay.
Stat.
Is it open bar or no?
Yes, open bar.
Oh my God, I gotta go. I gotta gotta go on a break. Thank you so much. It was nice meeting you. That's to our
fault. Yeah, absolutely. My name is Douglas Vermeeren, and I'm an actor. Done a lot of TV shows and also feature films. Just finished wrapping the big film, How to Be a Hitman 101. Do I look like a hitman?
Oh. I mean, what does a hitman really look like?
Maybe like this. Maybe like this.
Okay, now I have a point of reference.
Yeah, fair enough.
I'm sorry. So How to Be a Hitman, when does that come out? I want to see it.
We've still, I think, got about 2 more weeks of shooting, and I think they're talking either about the late summer or early fall with
okay,
it.
Okay, are you having a premiere for them?
We are, for sure, okay. Absolutely.
Well, here at Duke and Duchess TV, we love
you're invited. I'd love to have you as my guest, please.
Please give you a business card. Please contact us.
I would love to have you.
And, you know, and it was a pleasure meeting you. Is there anything that you're most excited for this evening?
Wow, this evening, so I've been nominated for an acting award, so we'll see what happens there.
Oh, you're getting your Oscar today.
Yeah, I've been getting my Oscar today. So I'm pretty excited about that. But also, I mean, it's just great to reconnect with friends and others that I know at these events. There's a lot of really talented and creative people that are here. So we're very excited about these kinds of things, and what a great time.
Yes, well, it's been a pleasure meeting you, and congratulations on everything.
Thank you so much.
Of course, I'm Brooklyn Bailey. I'm 14 years old, and I'm inspired to be a runway model.
You're 14?
I am 14.
Oh my God! Congratulations. This is big. You're in there. You go ahead, all girl.
Thank you so much.
So at 14, what made you decide you wanted to model?
I've always had a passion for runway modeling, and I've done it actually since I was 11. But I'm super excited. I'm going to be in LA Fashion Week next week, and then I'm walking in Brooklyn Fashion Week in April.
Congratulations! That's amazing! So earlier you mentioned you were wearing someone. Can you tell our followers?
I am wearing Kiki Wang, and you'll see me later tonight also wearing her outfit.
Kiki Wang! Wow, congratulations. I love this outfit, actually. It's like party on top, business on the bottom, kind of.
Exactly. I love it so much. It's really easy to like wear. It's super light. I love it. It's pretty.
It's pretty. I love anything with tulle, so.
It's super high fashion, too. Kiki Wang's a high fashion designer.
So, you got Fashion Week coming up. Is this mind-blowing for you? Because I would be mind-blown.
It is. It's actually my first LA Fashion Week, but I'm super excited.
You're going to the top. You know that, right?
You.
You're gonna be. Have you been in Vogue yet?
No.
Okay, well, you're going to be in Vogue.
I'm super excited because actually Kiki Wang is a Vogue and Bazaar designer. So.
Yeah. You're like 2 steps from Vogue already. So.
Thank you.
You're there. Is there anything that you'd like to share with our followers or with Samira Network or anything to sign off with?
Sure. I'd like to say that the sky is not the limit. Like, you can always go higher.
34th Miss Annual Asia, yeah.
So, okay. I'm here with Miss Asia, okay? So, shut everything down. All of Asia, okay? Miss Asia, like the whole thing.
Oh, it was actually a pretty big shock to me because I went and all the girls were so amazed and I was like, oh my god, this is like a real thing. Like this is actual competition. And so we had to do a talent portion, we had to do a little show portion, and it was just really based on what the judges were really looking for.
Wow, what was your talent?
I did tap dancing.
Tap dancing? Okay, Miss Asia tap dances, y'all.
My name's Selena.
Selena Dye. Yeah. Nice to meet you. So congratulations, first of all, on winning Miss Asia. So what made you get into that?
So I originally started off as a model, and I was just really just like, oh, let's just do this fun little thing. And eventually it led up to this, and I was like, it's great. You know, I'm living the life and experiencing everything as young as I can.
Okay, so I know everybody's just stunned by your dress. Like, this dress is unbelievable. Where do you even get something like this?
So I'm actually here with Kiki Wang, the designer for this dress.
Kiki Wang designed that?
Designed it.
Wow. Oh my god. Okay, everybody's been getting Kiki Wang but me. You gotta connect me.
I got you.
Connect me, because I wanna look like this. I wanna look like this. You look amazing.
I'm 15.
Shut up.
I'm 15.
You are lying. How are you 15? I didn't think you were like old or nothing. Like, don't get me wrong, but I'm like, that's a huge accomplishment to be so young. What is next for you?
Hopefully I can get signed with an agency and start walking shows around the world, like Paris. And
are you in Fashion Week coming up?
I am in Fashion Week.
Okay, who are you walking for?
I'm not sure yet, but we're gonna figure that out, and and hopefully I'll be on the runway.
You're gonna get signed. We'll see you in Vogue soon. Have you been in Vogue yet?
I'm actually coming out in a magazine for Vogue, but I'm not sure when it's coming out.
Yeah, I'm gonna buy some Vogue so I can find you. Well, congratulations on everything.
Thank you.
How can we keep up with you? Are you on Instagram?
I have an Instagram. It's SELINA period DAI underscore.
All right, well, congratulations. I'm so proud of you. You are doing it, and you're so young, and this dress and everything. Nice meeting you. We are here, and I'm with another model. We're meeting all the models today at this luxury gala event. You are new to Duke and Duchess TV. That's the name of our show. And we're so excited to be able to interview you all. You all look so amazing. I love your outfit.
Thank you.
So, tell us your name.
My name is Selina Yan. I'm a model from Hong Kong, China. I'm working in the field of fashion and education.
Wow, wow. Model from China.
Mm.
So you came all the way here?
Hey.
For this event. Wow. So are you living in China now or you live here?
I live in Hong Kong.
Still? Oh. Yeah, that's a long flight.
It's a great honor to wear Miss KK1's dress and stand here today. Red is my traveling color, you know? Red is traditional color of my country. It stands for joy, happiness, and luck.
Yes.
So I wish everyone around me joy, happiness, and good luck.
Thank you so much. And who we got? Mrs. Barat, Tennessee. Okay, come on, Tennessee. That is amazing. How do you get involved in something like that?
Actually, I saw from my Dream TV USA that they were encouraging so many women for participation and for Mrs. Bharat Rajni pageant. So that's how I got into it. I always had a passion, so I just...
Congratulations! That's amazing. And you got first runner-up. You should have won. But it's okay. You're still that girl, okay? You're still that girl. And I love your crown. That's so pretty. So what brings you here today?
Today we are here representing our fashion designer Vaishali. Her designs are attires, and we're walking for her at Oscars.
Oh, you're walking today? Oh, well, I'll be in the back screaming for you.
Thank you so much.
The fashion show, is there anything else you're excited to see at this event?
Yes, to see the entire event, to meet you.
Yes, to meet you too, yes.
To see everyone, any celebrities who have been an encouragement for so many of us. So yeah, I would love to see everyone.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
My name is Angel White. I am 48 years old, a grandmother of 5, and a mother of 3.
A grandmother? Whose grandma are you? You look like you should be nobody's grandma. Where are you based out of?
San Diego.
Okay, there you go. In the house. All right.
Yeah. I'm so because I'm getting into modeling and acting and music. I'm actually signed with Motsby Talent Agency.
Yeah. Congratulations. That's huge. That is so huge.
Yeah.
Okay, so where will we see you? Are you walking today?
No, not today. I'm networking, but like I came up here for networking because it says a lot about who you know, and it's always network. So I do have a virtual audition with The Voice, and I did get signed with Avanti Scouting Management, and I'm also in the March issue of Fashion Republic magazine.
Whoa, congratulations. You better go head on out here. Congratulations, that's huge. That's a major accomplishment.
I have another modeling thing out here March 25th to go on the April issue of Fashion Republic.
Okay, how you get in that?
Girl, FashionRepublic.com.
FashionRepublic.com. We don't remember that.
So you could do it.
Thank you. Oh, man, I'm so excited for you. I'm going to be watching for you. The Voice. Fingers crossed.
It's a virtual, so, you know, I do all types of genres.
I'm watching for you. We root for you over here. We are live here at the Luxury Gala again. And who do I have? Miss Fashion Global 2023. That's this year. So, that is this year. Wow. How do you get that achievement?
This achievement is a very, very honorable title. It's given for recognition of humanitarian and service work performed locally and globally.
Wow. Yep. So what kind of work did you do to get that award?
I'm Army veteran, so I've served my country.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. I've been involved in service all of my life. I have a One Hope wine business that is impact driven. It gives back 10% locally and globally to all charities in need. One thing about Miss Fashion Global, we also have our own humanitarian charity, Operation Save, social aid for everyone. And we as humanitarian queens, we step up. We help anyone suffering anytime, anywhere, without bias, judgment, or prejudice. We are just there.
That's amazing.
Yes.
So what brings you to this event?
Invited by Heart of Hollywood magazine, and I want to give them a huge thank you for having me. I'm very grateful.
Oh, that's wonderful. Is there anything you're most excited for this event today?
I am most excited to see, I think, Tom Cruise get his well-deserved Oscar for Maverick. He did a phenomenal job. He always astounds the audience. He went above and beyond. It's well-deserved. I'm very excited for that.
How exciting. Yeah. Well, it's been such a pleasure talking
with
you. Your dress is beautiful.
Thank you kindly.
Can you share who you're wearing?
Yes, this is another part of my service. This is from my former hometown in Johnstown, Pennsylvania. The economy is struggling there, so I went and I bought this dress at the Bridal Suite in Richland Township, Johnstown, Pennsylvania. Supporting local businesses there.
Shop local.
Yes, shop local. I traveled just to get this dress.
I love that. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
And I'm sure they're happy that you are representing for them.
Thank you.
Yes, it's very nice meeting you. Congratulations on everything.
Thank you.
Okay, we are here live at the Luxury Gala, and oh my God, I'm so excited because I have not seen this lady in so long, and I'm really excited because we're both from fellow Stocktonians.
Yes, Stocktonians.
Yes. So, Miss Rachel, how are you?
I am just elated to be here. I'm so excited. This is my first gala, and so I am just elated to be here.
Yeah. Are you still cooking?
I'm still cooking. Actually, I have my cooking show, which is Breakfast is Beautiful, that airs on Roku and will soon be on Netflix.
Really?
Yes.
Oh my God, congratulations!
Thank you, and then
that's
also,
huge!
I'm also an author, and this is my new book that's out, called Humble, a children's book which she fights bullies.
Okay, where can we get this book at?
You can get this book on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and Arthur Reputation Press.
Okay, Rachel, you've been busy.
Yes.
You've been busy.
Too busy, girl.
You went MIA. You've been busy.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Well, I'm so excited and proud for you.
Yes, thank you.
I'm so happy to see you. Give me a hug.
Oh, my gosh.
We are here live at the Luxury Gala, and I'm here with the awesome Ike, who has this really nice jacket, I must say, on. Very nice. And I see you got your pins there. What are those? The print is really small. What are those?
This award was given to me by President Joe Biden for my Lifetime Achievement Award for Humanitarian Services of 50 years.
You met him in person?
Yes.
You shook his hand and everything?
Everything.
Oh my God, how was that? Was he nice?
It was lovely. It was lovely. Very appreciative.
Is he taller?
That they recognized. Oh yeah, I had to look up.
Okay, so you got a humanitarian award.
I got a humanitarian award, but my position is that I'm the president of the United Nations Association here in Inland Empire,
okay.
USA.
Yeah.
And we are civil society arm for the UN.
Wow.
And we work for the humanity, we work humanitarian projects, we support UN Charter from human rights to every sustainable goals, which are 17 goals.
Wow.
And which is for the betterment, upliftment, and equal distribution for the public of the world.
Okay.
8 billion people.
Yeah.
So we are part of it, we are the largest in the world.
Is that stressful?
Well, if you love it, it's not as stressful.
Okay, that makes sense.
You have to love your humanity. You love to have your brothers and sisters. And then you just do whatever you do in the best possible way. Even the smallest step is a big you know, support to every community around the globe.
That's beautiful. And you say you're in the Inland Empire doing this?
I'm based from there, but we are global.
Okay.
We are all connected.
I live in the Inland Empire.
Oh, you do? Yes. I live in the city of Corona.
Oh, okay. You're not too far. I'm in San Bernardino. I just got my master's at Cal State, so that's why I'm there.
I'm going there, yeah, because my territory is Inland Empire.
Wow.
Which includes San Bernardino County and Riverside County.
Right.
But we are local presence with global outlook.
Wow. Well, thank you so much for all the work you're doing. That's amazing.
Thank you so much.
And I'm going to reach out to you. Duke and Duchess TV wants to reach out to you.
I love this environment. I love the people. I love the message. I love the energy. It's good for the people. It's bringing them together. And the best part is a chunk of money is going to the Cancer Hope Foundation. You know, that's a charitable work. So, you know, hats off to Samira.
Yes.
Hats off to the Gala team.
Yes.
And they have brought up a very good program.
Yes, thank you so much. It was really awesome meeting you.
Thank you.
We are here live at the Luxury Gala. I love your look. You are so sparkles.
Thank you.
I love it. So you're new to the Duke and Duchess TV program, so would you mind introducing yourself to our followers?
Yes, my name is Rosetta Walker, and I am the Queen of Inspiration. I'm also an actress, motivational speaker.
Well, very nice meeting you. And I see you got a
nice
book here.
You. Yes.
Did you write this? This is
yes, I'm in this book, a best-selling author, along with Les Brown.
How do I get a copy?
Oh, you can get a copy. Just Google, and you can see all my materials. Where's music? Let me just give you a quick copy of that.
Okay. I'd love to have you on my podcast sometime.
All right.
Talk
great.
About it. Okay. Yes. And I love your dress. Who made it? Who are you wearing, if you don't mind sharing?
I'm wearing Rosetta Walker.
Okay.
Well, I was in this movie, Canaanland, last year, and was up for Best Supporting Actress for consideration.
Okay.
So I'm really excited about that.
Congratulations. Yeah. Congratulations on everything you're doing.
All right, thank you.
Yes. Well, I'll be reaching out to you, girl.
All right. Sounds good, everybody.
Nice meeting you. I'm super excited for this next person. You know him. He's the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Purple in Stockton. The well-known Orlando Jose, and we got Mr. Purple.
Yeah, Mr. Purple, y'all. Yeah, we're just seeing how the night brings, and you know, I'm glad to see new faces and meeting old friends and seeing everybody come together.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. What are you most excited about for this event?
The food.
Okay, where that food at?
I know, I'm looking for the food.
Nikki D is hungry. Okay.
Yeah, right.
And so you're not filming today. You're usually behind the camera. How does it feel? You're walking another red carpet again.
Oh my God, it's different. I never did it. Now experiencing it, walking, yes. Seeing how everybody gets questions. Usually we do the questions, but yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I see you brought Mr. Purple. What you got to say?
Mr. Purple at 209 Instagram.
Yes.
I do birthday parties, commercials, hire me. I need it.
Yes.
The struggle is real.
I feel you. Is there any message you'd like to share with the community or Samira Network?
Yeah, thank you to Samira Network and everybody that put this together to make it happen.
Yes. Thank you very much and congratulations.
And he's working on a new project called Pyrogenesis, which is about the early inception of the Bloods and the Crips in South Central Los Angeles.
Wow. What got you into such heavy topics like that?
Well, I did a film about the murders of Tupac and Biggie. I did a film about Suge Knight. I did a film about the Mexican cartels. So this all kind of led me in this direction.
Okay. You like the heavy drama.
No, I mean, that's where the story is, right? The story is they're on that edge between life and death.
Yes.
And you know, there's so much that goes on now in the hood with the red and the blue. If you're wearing the wrong color and you're in the wrong neighborhood, you're going to be murdered just for wearing the wrong color. And it's time for us all to look back at how it all started and go beyond red and blue, all the way to the top. And it's not about red and blue. It's about people. We need to start looking at how to benefit people, humanity.
I like that. And what about you? Are you excited for anything this evening?
I'm just here to support my husband and enjoy the evening.
I love that. What about you? Are you excited?
I'm excited for Michael's projects, and also I'm hoping my personal favorite is I'm hoping for Elvis to be a good winner tonight out of the 10 great candidates.
Did you see
I did. I saw it twice.
Oh, you saw it twice.
I grew up with Elvis. When I was a little boy, a tornado hit our town in Macomb, Mississippi. Elvis Presley's cousin lived there, so he came to town and did a fundraiser at the high school for the victims of the tornado.
Wow. Well,
1975.
I hope that's a good story, so I hope it works out.
I hope so.
All right. Well, thank you. It was a pleasure meeting you all. I love your ensemble. You look amazing. You look so good.
You too.
Thank you. Thank you. I try, you know. So, you're new to Duke and Duchess TV. We never interviewed you before. So, would you mind introducing yourself to our followers?
Sure. So, my name is Laura Powers. I'm a celebrity psychic, actress and model, and host.
Oh my God, you're a celebrity psychic?
Yes.
That's amazing. I love that. I love that. I'm a huge fan of celebrity psychics.
Amazing.
So, who's like the most famous person you worked with?
Well, I was actually interviewed by Will Ferrell on his podcast, the Ron Burgundy podcast. A lot of the clients I work with, I sign NDAs, so we're talking major celebrities, but I can't say their names. But I have worked with Tori Spelling as someone that people would know, and she gave me permission.
Okay. So do you, when you're doing this, like, how do you do it, I guess is my question.
Yeah.
I know it's a gift.
But absolutely.
Like, how did you discover that you had this?
So ever since I was little, I've seen and sensed ghosts, so that's how I knew I had abilities. And it's just like anything, there's training and practice, so I've just honed this. I've been a professional psychic for 12 years.
Wow.
And yeah, it's information I get through my clairvoyance, which means seeing, and then also I'm claircognizant, I just know things.
Okay. Does it happen randomly?
It happens when I do a reading, I focus like 100% on that, and then I do just get things pop in all the time.
Wow, that's amazing. You are so lucky. I'm so jealous.
One thing I want everyone to know, though, is that you can get training, and everyone has some natural ability. It's just most people have never learned how to tap into it.
That's true. I read a lot about like mediums and afterlife and things like that. I'm really into that kind of thing. So I've learned a little bit, but not as much as you, of course. But I've learned a little bit and try to get people to be more accepting of that sort of thing.
Yeah, I think we're shifting as a society, and more people believe it and are working at it, which is great.
So do you have anything you'd like to sign off with before we end this interview?
You know, I would just, one thing, message I get from angels and spirit guides all the time is how much more powerful we think we are, or we are than we think we are. So for everyone to know that they are extremely powerful and they can really manifest their dreams.
Thank you so much. It was really nice meeting you. We are here live at the Luxury Gala for the Oscar viewing. And first of all, your outfit's amazing.
Thank you. Thank you.
What brings you out today?
Well, I was invited to be a host for tonight. I'm supposed to be doing what you're doing on the red carpet, but this is my leisure time to meet a lot of people. A lot of people that I have ran into, the old friends from before the corona came. I usually do the Oscars every year, but I'm performing, supposed to be performing tonight.
Yay.
For this, but we're trying to get that together. But anyway, okay. I do a Michael Jackson tribute show in Vegas and Los Angeles too as well. So right now I'm just trying to get my things going with my Michael Jackson show for the children.
Okay.
In the hospitals, trying to get back to the hospitals for the Heal the World Foundation. Go back to South Africa, and it's just amazing that we're all here without the masks.
I know. It's unbelievable.
It's such a beautiful thing. So any questions you want to like to ask me or anything?
Yes. First of all, how do we find you on social media?
It's Scorpio, OG Scorpio on Instagram, and Renato Spicer and Facebook.
Okay. Now I do want to know, how did you decide that you wanted to be a Michael Jackson tribute artist?
Well, a friend of mine back in the early 90s slapped makeup on my face and pulled my hair down in my face and said, you know, you look just like Michael Jackson. That's when Michael Jackson had the Bad album. And he said, oh, you look just like the Bad album. So we went, because we used to do contests, lip sync contests in different cities. And we won first place by me doing Michael Jackson Bad. Only thing I did was spin and backslide. And we won first place. And everywhere we went, we won first place.
Wow, that's
so
amazing.
And then it was history after that. Danced on Soul Train for many years.
Ooh.
American Bandstand. Don Cornelius sent me and about four other guys to Japan, to Osaka, and Tokyo to do a show, open up for the acrobats.
Wow.
Yeah, so after that, it was history.
And now you're here with me. I feel so honored.
Yeah. Thank you.
Well, is there anything specific? I know you're trying to perform today. I really hope that they work that out, because I'd love to see you perform.
Yes.
But is there anything else that you're looking forward to this evening?
just meeting great people, exchanging business cards, getting more work, having people notice who I am in the entertainment world. And that's where I want to be. That's my next goal, to be in the Oscars, to be in all the award shows, red carpets. Just trying to get my name out there.
Yes.
As MJ tribute artist.
MJ tribute art. I love it. I love it. And you definitely have the look, the whole look. I love it for
you. Thank you so much.
I know you're going to do it. I know I'm going to see you again.
Thank you so much. Yeah, you will.
Could you introduce yourself?
My name's Patrick Lowe. When I was younger, I was an actor. I was on Days of Our Lives, Young and the Restless. Also, I starred in two films, and I exited that career when I was 25 because I felt like God wanted more in my life. So I'm a financial advisor, and I am married to the Queen.
What? Yeah!
I am!
No wonder you're so stoked!
I gotta tell you, I'm jazzed. I really am. I'm blessed.
You are.
I'm blessed. Everybody's blessed in some way, shape, or form, but this has been my blessing. But
Wow. How'd you get into financial advice?
I thank God. I'm serious. So we're very fortunate to be blessed in that business. We have a highly successful business at Morgan Stanley, and so I'm just... Charlie's the host. And she's the hostess for the mostest.
Yes. So what's your best piece of financial advice?
Don't be afraid to invest. Fixed income's great. 4% money markets. Keep bonds short duration. And don't be afraid to buy some high-quality stocks.
All right. I love it. Thank you so much.
Yeah. It's all about her.
Oh, okay.
She's a product sponsor.
Okay. Hi. All right, we are live here at the Luxury Gala, and you look so, so beautiful. You are wearing that white. Thank you. You are doing it.
Pastor Michael Christian from Detroit, Michigan.
Wow. I need that number. Michael Christian, call me, please, because I got to look like this. So, you're new to Duke and Duchess TV. We've never interviewed you before. So, would you mind introducing yourself?
Absolutely. Tiffany Cartwright, Glam Body Scrubs.
Wow. So, what brings you out today?
So, I am here celebrating tonight. My Glam Body Scrubs have just landed in Target and Walmart stores nationwide, and they are featured tonight in the swag bag. So, we're a product sponsor. Everyone is going home with Glam Body Scrubs in their swag bags.
Oh, I got to get mine. I'm at the Luxury Gala, and I'm here with none other than Ewart Chen. I haven't seen you in so long.
I know. It's great to be here.
How have you been?
I've been so busy. I just wrapped a movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger's son last week. We're getting ready to produce another big movie. It's a cowboy musical called Key to the West. And we just signed Connie Talbot from Britain's Got Talent.
Wow.
And it's going to be amazing.
Wow, that's amazing. I think the last time we saw each other was at that party with Quincy Jones.
Yes, I remember.
And I had to walk down that hill.
I remember. Yes.
So it's so good to see you. I did not know you were coming, but I'm really excited to see you because I haven't seen you in so long.
Thank you.
Glad you're doing really well.
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Yes.
Just for you, I'm forever.
Support groups, workshops, educational workshops, fun workshops, and we have individual healing modalities like Reiki, Qigong, reflexology, acupuncture, so many other wonderful things to enhance the body, mind, and spirit to help relieve the effects of the cancer diagnosis and its treatment. So I thank you very much. What a fun night! I love the Oscars, and I'm even having more fun than I ever have.
Fashion show and the Spring Diamonds fashion show. He has done incredible things. He's won the best national costume many times in international events and pageants. Also gracing the stage is the Red Queen of Fashion, none other than Kiki Wang. You'll be seeing her designs later. Kiki Wang Fashion, known as the Red Queen of Fashion, Wang has dressed a number of Hollywood celebrities, royals, international supermodels, news anchors, and social influencers, and I will be sharing with you more about her as the night progresses.
If you have a woman, you'd like to bring that out. Thank you so much, and Kiki. And actually, you did something that had never been done in Chinese history, but I'll get to that in a moment. Let's exit stage left, and then you'll see them as the night progresses.
huge round of applause for Sir Earl Toon. I'm going to sing two other songs tonight, but I'm coming back and listening. You guys are just going to even have a party. I'd love for you to get down on the other end, celebrating and fresh and all that. But I want to say something. We have to, with all the power that's in this room, Samira and Kamara Helm is here, take the opportunity to meet and greet each other. Because there's so many things that we can do for so many others. Okay? Please, do that. And I want to thank Martina Webster and Jeff Reynolds and Doc Skinner and Dalia Faulkner. All these people were the reason why I'm here with Samira. So I thank you so very much.
This is a part of American history, part of American culture. We're excited. You don't know all about this just yet, but we're going to be going on a tour with the Nelson Mandela Foundation together, along with the Martin Luther King family. We're going to be doing a global tour about uniting us and stepping into the greatest. So share some words, please, and introduce us to your grasshopper.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This man used to serve Highland, Redford. We're working together with WWE to travel the world. But most importantly, the hospital thing wasn't the only one that was cocky in the ring. It was Hector, no, it was Macho Camacho. And he dropped and he turned over his legacy to his son. Hector Camacho is my godson for many years.
Thank you for having him. He's a legend from Egypt, and he's the most popular singer in the Middle East. Steve Hawkins, the star, Waleed Tawfiq. Yeah, but just to let you know, he's born in Lebanon.